गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द लेक्चर ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। सो हेयर वी विल डिस्कस द सीपीयू शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम। मेनली देर आर four type of the CPU scheduling algorithm. The first is FCFS, first come first serve. The next is shortest job first, SJF. थर्ड इज प्रायोरिटी ड्रिवन एल्गोरिथम। एंड द लास्ट वन इज राउंड रॉबिन सीपीयू शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम। Now we will discuss one by one. So first we are going to discuss the FCFS, first come first serve CPU scheduling algorithm. First of all, I want to tell about the CPU scheduling algorithm. CPU is the central processing unit of the operating system. What is the meaning of that? There are number of process will come from the memory to the CPU. The CPU will run process one by one. For that purpose, we have the different scheduling queue, and we have to choose the scheduling queue on the different categories with the help of the FCFS, first come first serve. So we will take one by one. So we are taking the one example for that. We have the process. Process name will be there just like the A, B, C and D. Now we will take the CPU bus time. The CPU bus time is the time the process will take over the CPU, just like 15, 10, 12 and 5. All are in millisecond. Now we will schedule our process according to the FCFS, first come first serve. What is the meaning of first come first serve? We will follow the process order to run the process one by one. We will follow the process order. Here just we assume the process order according to the alphabets A, B, C and D. As like, first we will take the process A, after that we will take process B, then C, then D. That is the CPU bus time of the process. For that, to solve that, we will use the Gantt chart. So Gantt chart is a chart which will be used to schedule the algorithm according to the FCFS, and in other algorithm also we will use. That particular chart is provided by the scientist Gantt, so the name is Gantt chart. So here first we will take the start from the zero, after that we will take the according to the process order, process A. Then process A from where? 0 to the 15. After that we will go for the process B. The process B will take the time 10. What is the meaning of time 10? It will go up to the 25. After that process C will take time 12. It will go it will go 25 plus 12, that will go to the 37. Next is process D. It will take time. So next we will take the schedule according to the Gantt chart. Now we will calculate the average waiting time. We will calculate the average waiting time. Average waiting time, we are writing here the AWT. What is the meaning of average waiting time? That time is the average of all waiting times. So what is the waiting for process A? Waiting for process A, waiting of process B plus waiting of process C plus waiting of process D. Now we will take the waitings. The waiting of A we can calculate from the Gantt chart. First we are taking the 0, that is the waiting of process A, 0. Process B, the waiting of process B is 15. The waiting of process C is 25, and the waiting of process D is 37. Now we will sum of all waiting times. 15 plus 25, 40, plus 37, 77. Now for to average waiting time, what we will do, we will take that 77, divide by the number of process, 77 AWT, 77 divide by the number of process. Number of process is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what will be the result? So 4 19 19.25 millisecond, that is the average waiting time of the FCFS. So that is the first algorithm, FCFS. Here we are calculating the average waiting time of. Now we can write that AWT of FCFS is 19.25 millisecond. That will be the reference for the next CPU scheduling algorithm. Now we will go for the second CPU algorithm. The question will be the same. Here we will change the name to shortest job first. As the name, we have the shortest job first. The meaning of the shortest job first is that which job will have the least CPU burst time. So then we will take as the first process to run, after that the next shortest, then next shortest, and then next shortest. The sequence will be there. If we will consider that particular questions, so which will be the first, the process D will be the first algorithm. After that we will take the process B, after that the process C, and the last we will take the process A, which has the 15 millisecond the burst time. Again we can consider which is the shortest one. First we will take 5, after that we will take 10, after that 12, after that 15. So it has the process D, after that 10 for the process B, and 12 for the process C, and 15 for process A. So what will be the Gantt chart? Gantt chart will be as like. So first we will take D, after that B, 15 plus 10, 15, after that C, 15 plus 12, 27, and at last A, 27, 50, 42. The last digit will be the same, because that is the addition of all four process CPU bus time. So the addition in the last will be the same. So first we will run D, after that B, then C, then A. So that will be the sequence. Now we will calculate the average waiting time as like the first. For first we will take for the process A, waiting time of the A plus waiting time of B plus waiting time of C and waiting time of D. So we will calculate. After that, waiting time of A is 27. Here the waiting time of A is 27. We will take from the Gantt chart. After that, waiting time of B. The waiting time of B is 5. Waiting time of C. Waiting time of C is 15. After that, the waiting time of D. Waiting time of D is 0. So addition will be, so we can add is 27 plus 5, 32. 32 plus 15. 47. Then average waiting time, that is the average of all waiting times. We have the waiting times for A 27, for B 5, for C 15, for D 0. We can take the average of all. 47 divided by number of process, that is 47 divided by the 4. What will be the calculation? All units in the milliseconds, that will be the 11.75 millisecond. So every AWT of the SJF will be 11.75 millisecond. So that is the second algorithm. Now we will go for the third algorithm, that is the priority driven algorithm. For priority driven algorithm, first we have to take the priority also in the question. What is the priority? So the priorities can be given or may be given in the your textbook or in the exam paper. So we can take here, just we are taking the priority. The priority can be taken in the form of the numbers. The least the number, highest the priority, as the practice we follow in the textbook as well as in the exam. So the least the number, highest the priority. So what will be the priority? What will be the order of the process according to the priorities? What will be the D will be first according the priority number 1, first priority. We can take as like 1, 2, 3, 4. So first the 1 is allotted to D, process D. After that we will take the number 2, that is allotted to B. After take we will take the number 3, which is allotted to A. After we will take the number 4, which is allotted to C. So that will be the priorities accordingly. That will be the sequence of the, now we will make the Gantt chart. we will start from the 0. So first we will take D, then 5. After that we will take B, which has the worst time 10 10 plus 5 15. After that we will take the C, no, after we will take the A, because it has the priority number 3. So we will take the A, 15 plus 15 30. After that we will take, which is the last, C, 30 plus 12 42. That will be the sequence of the process. First the D, then next B, after that A, and then after C. So again we will calculate the average waiting time. So average waiting time of A plus waiting time of B and waiting time of C and waiting time of D. तो एक A का वेटिंग टाइम कितना है? तो वेटिंग टाइम ऑफ A इज 15, देन प्लस B का वेटिंग टाइम 5, प्लस देन C का वेटिंग टाइम 30, प्लस D का वेटिंग टाइम 0. सो व्हाट विल बी द टोटल? 20 प्लस 30 50. एवरेज वेटिंग टाइम, वेटिंग टाइम divide by the number of process. So what will be the ?12.5 milliseconds. So average waiting time of priority, that will be 12.5 milliseconds. Next we will go the last algorithm, that is the round robin scheduling algorithm. Fourth is round robin CPU scheduling algorithm. Again, so what is the main thing of the round robin CPU scheduling algorithm? So we can understand the round robin CPU scheduling algorithm. What will be the major part of that? That algorithm likes the we can take as the example of the Golgappa. What is the meaning of that? When we will go to the eat Golgappa, the slices given to the customer one by one. So the sequence will be follow in rounds. सो दैट एल्गोरिथम विल फॉलो द गोलगप्पा वाला. सो हेयर दैट इज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दैट. We will start from the zero. So what is the first we have to introduce the time slice or quantum, which is we can introduce. So here we are taking 4 millisecond. So first we have to take the process order will be follow in the round robin FCP scheduling algorithm. The process order will be follow as well as the time slice will be given at a time. So we are taking the example. So what we will take, just we will take the A, process A, because in the process order the process A is the first. So we will give the time 4. After that process B, again 8, C 12, D 16. So we will minus 1 by 1, 4 minus 4 minus 4. That is the first phase. In the second phase, what we will do, again we will give according to processor order, we can take from the A 20, we are taking the schedule to the next line. From 20, we will take B 24, then C minus 4, minus 4, then C, again we can take from the C 28, from D. Here we will see that C have only 1 remaining 1 millisecond. So we will just take the 1. Here the C is complete. Now we will, we do not take the C in the next round. So that is the round 2 minus 1. Now we will go for the round 3. Again we will take the A